So part two of lesson 12 on electricity. So we just finished up talking about electric force and charge. And the reason why we learn about those things is so we can talk about electrical circuits, and we're going to talk about what are called DC circuits or direct current circuits. So first we're going to define the different variables that we're going to look at. So we're going to look at current, which is the variable I. And it's the rate at which electrical charges flow through a point in a wire. So it's how fast those charges move going through the wire. So current equals the change in charge, or triangle Q, divided by time. So if you know how much charge is flowing through a particular point and how much time it takes for those charges to flow through, you can figure out the current. To get charges to move in current, you need something to push it along, which is something called the voltage or potential difference. So most of the time I just use V, the symbol V for it. And this is usually measured in volts, and it's supplied by the battery. So the battery, if you look at your battery, has a voltage rating on it. Finally, going back to current, current is measured in amps. So the unit should be A, capital A. And I think I left that out, so that's a capital A. And then resistance is the opposition to the flow of electrical current, and this is provided by any device that it is using to do the work. So light bulbs, speakers, whatever is using that electrical energy for, that's what's providing resistance. So the unit for resistance is called an ohm, and it's the Greek letter omega here, and that's a volt per amp. So one thing that we use to help people better understand kind of current going through wires and electricity is water and pipes. So kind of this is an analogy between the two. So the stuff that's moving through the water and the pipe is the actual water, and we call that water motion the current. With electricity, when we talk about the electrons are the things that are moving, and we call it an electrical current, which is the letter I. The thing that causes the motion is the water pressure. So if you imagine water in your house, the pressure is what pushes the water through it. The voltage is essentially the electrical pressure, and it comes from the electrical force kind of aspect of charges. And then finally, using motion to do work, that's the water wheel example here. So the water hits the water wheel, it slows down, and it uses this motion and energy in the water to move this wheel, and that would be sort of your motor or your light bulb or whatever you're powering. The resistor is what provides that in your circuit, so it uses this motion of electrons to power whatever device.
So I paused for a while, so I've kind of lost track of where I was saying, but just this chart kind of summarizes and helps people get a better idea of like how to relate electrical ideas with electricity going through wires and circuits, and then water going through pipes in that analogy. So I think I covered that, so we'll keep going. So we're going to do this basic circuit demonstration. So I already have it kind of mostly set up already. So you're going to use the simulation right here. It says circuit construction kit DC. That's the next simulation you're going to be working on when we talk about series and parallel circuits, and then combination circuits eventually. But to make it go a little faster, I already set it up. So here there's the circuit that has a 1 volt battery and a 10 ohm resistor. And then we have a voltmeter over here, which measures the voltage across some item, which happens to be our light bulb or resistor. And then the current that's going through the wire. If you track one of these electrons, you can see that the electron's actually moving, even though it's very slow, and that's 0.1 amp. So if we go back to our value here, we should put 0.1 for the current. So we're going to increase the voltage or the push or the pressure and see what happens to the current when we have a constant resistance of 10. So you probably would imagine that as you increase the pressure, if you think about it in terms of water, if you increase the water pressure, then the water should go faster. That's generally what happens. So we would expect this current value for the electrical current to go up as well. So let's go ahead and go back to the simulation, and we're going to just increase this battery voltage. So we're going to go from 1 to 2, and you see it went to 0.2, and I'm going to do this a couple times, up to 3, and it's 0.3. 4 and 0.4 for the current, and then finally 5 and 0.5. I think the last one where we increase is all the way up to 10 volts. So 10 volts, you get 1 amp of current. This is 1 ohm of resistance, and you can see the light bulb as the pressure got bigger, the electrical pressure or the voltage got bigger, the charges moved faster, and we produced more electrical power, which makes sense. So coming back to this and just typing in those numbers, so this one was 0.2, and then 0.3, and then 0.4, and 0.5, and then it was, let me stop there, and then I'll put another one, and that was 1 amp. So that was this one. So now we're going to keep that voltage the same. So in general, what we got out of this, as this voltage gets bigger with a constant resistance, so these resistors are all at 10, the current increase. So that's one relationship. And then now we're going to look for the other relationship, which is looking at how current is affected by resistance. So as the resistance gets bigger, in this next section here, we're going to look at if R, or the resistance, increases, what's going to happen to I. So resistance is what's like slowing down the electrons. So we should expect, I think, that the current would drop. The more resistance there is, the less current that's going to go through. So we're going to go back to this simulation, and we're going to change the resistance. So I'm going to change it from, let me go back in a second, to 10 to 20 to 30 to 40 to 50. So again, just so I don't keep clicking back and forth, we're going to go 10 to 20. That was 21. 10 to 20, I got 0.5. If I increase it up to 30, we got 0.33, 40, 0.25, and then finally 50 is 0.2. So let's go ahead and plug in those numbers. So this was, I type these in. This went to 0.5. All right, so I plugged in those numbers in our chart, and we look at it and see that as the resistance increases, the current decreases, which is what we expected. So there's an equation that relates voltage, current, and resistance. So if you look at these, how could you take the voltage and the resistance and end up with the current? What would you do with these numbers? So let me give you a second to think there. So if I had 10 and 10, I want to get 1, or if I have 1 and 10, I want to get 0.1. Or I have 5 and 10, and I want to get 0.5. Hopefully you can see the trend, which is really just its division. So the equation is the current is equal to the voltage divided by the resistance, or the voltage equals the current times the resistance. This is the more common way you see it in textbooks, and this is known as Ohm's law. So we're going to use Ohm's law to solve for various things. We're also going to use this equation for electric power, which is capital P. Electric power is like power that we talked about when we were talking about work, power, and energy. So power in electrical power sense is, you know, the amount of electrical energy used in a given amount of time. So the equation for it, our formula is P equals IV. The unit, again, I think I skipped that. The unit is still watts, just like your light bulbs or microwave ovens. That's the symbol or unit for power. So you just know, if you know the current, you know the voltage, you can multiply them together to get the power. You can also do these equations down here depending on what you're given. It's just using Ohm's law. So let's go through and practice a couple problems, and then I'll let you go. So the first one says a 9-volt battery is hooked up to a 25-ohm resistor. What is the current in the circuit? So the first part, you're looking for I, and you know V, and you know R. So you're given that information. Get rid of that. So you're given that information of the voltage, the resistance, and part B, it says how much charge will pass a given point in a circuit every 2 minutes. So the time for that is 2 minutes. Part C asks you to find the power. So we're looking for I, the current in part A, the charge, the amount of charge in part B, and the power in part C. So it's really just using those equations that we've looked at so far. So V equals IR, you know V and R, and you're solving for I, so you get 0.36 for the current. For the Q is I, the current equation is charge divided by time. You're looking for the charge Q. So if you solve that for Q using your answer to A for the current, and you divide Q by 120, so you multiply both sides by 120, and you get 43.6 coulombs, or I'm sorry, 43.2 coulombs, it's a lot of coulombs. And then for power, you do the current times the voltage, so 0.36, oh, I think I messed that up, let me fix it. It should be 9 volts, not 25, I meant multiplied by R. So this number is different as well. So 0.36. times 9 is 3.24 watts. Sorry for that, but I fixed it and hopefully didn't mess anybody up. So just the current, our answer to A, times the voltage, which was 9. So that's good. So
that's the first kind of problem. Just some schematic symbols. So a lot of times I'll ask you to draw pictures, sort of like what you have on the simulation. So like, you know how this is a simulation. If we change it to the schematic version of it, let me get rid of these voltmeters and ammeters. It kind of changed it into what would look like on a blueprint or a schematic for electrical diagrams. So this isn't exactly the way that it looks on our symbols that I have in the notes, but it's close enough that you can see that's a resistor and a switch. And a wire and a battery, and then a light bulb is just a specialized resistor, essentially. So going back to the notes, these are the most familiar kind of symbols that we use for those different things. So you're going to be asked to draw some. So it says draw a circuit diagram to include these following things. So a 60-volt battery, a 12.5-ohm resistor, a closed switch, and a wire connecting all the components. So I drew that over here. So we got our battery, our resistor, our closed switch, and the wires are connecting it. You could have put things in different orders. It doesn't really make a difference right now because we only have one resistor or bulb per circuit. And then we're going to do the same kind of math to figure out what's the current going through and what's the power use. So we know V and R, so we can solve for I. So very similar to what we did last time. You get 4.8 amps for the current in this problem. And then for the last part here, we're looking for the power. So the current times the voltage, so 4.8, our answer to A. Or probe B, excuse me, times 60 volts. So when you multiply that, you get 288. So that's the basics of circuits, and hopefully that'll help you better understand it.